Oh, how do
So
I get that terrain, by the
this terrain?
Yeah.
Don't know. I don't know. I think you have to buy it.
I can't find it in the store.
Oh yeah. It's not tradable and not purchasable anymore. Yeah, it's not tradable, not purchasable.
I think he can mod it actually.
Yeah, then you'll be able to see it. Yeah, I'm sure you should be able to mod it. I don't know. I'm not sure.
I was just curious about that. Okay, so here's the game. I was a Slark.
Okay, you were the Slark. All right.
I think I forgot agility boots. Yeah, I forgot agility boots, so I grabbed those. Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm
So
going for the early poor man's shield because a friend recommended it for me instead of getting the quilling blade because it achieves the same thing and it's good for blocking damage. Is that true?
all right. So the difference between poor man's shield and the difference between stout shield and poor man's shield is that stout shield has a 50% chance to block 16 melee damage, 8 range damage
Okay.
from creeps as well as heroes. It's just flat out 50% chance. Right? Poor man's shield, on the other hand, has still got a 50%. Where's the eye? God damn it.
Just there's a way to
There
close
we
that door.
go.
Okay, no.
Right. So poor man's shield has still a 50% chance to block slightly higher damage from creeps, so 20 damage from melee and 10 damage from range, but it has a 100% chance, like, so it completely blocks out 20 melee and 10 ranged damage from heroes.
Okay. It also
So
gives 6 agility. So it's like a
it
stat
also
for
gives
agility.
6 agility, but that's not really that huge. 6 agility is not that big a deal. It's almost one armor, which is okay, and it is 6 damage on an agility hero, which is again okay. On melee heroes, you almost always want a Quelling Blade, depending on the hero, but even though the Quelling Blade has been nerfed, it is still really, really important that you do get a Quelling Blade, especially if your last hitting suffers a little bit. And in your bracket, I can guarantee you that your last hitting will be suffering. So, Quelling Blade, you didn't really need Slippers of Agility. You don't need Poor Man's Shield this early, especially. On Slark, you can get Poor Man's Shield, especially if you are going to jungle quickly and effectively and efficiently. But to be honest, it's kind of it is a waste of money if you don't need it. And maybe we'll get into a situation later on where we can talk about when you need it or when you don't. But definitely save your gold, 190 gold you would have had, and then start of the game. 10 seconds later, you go to the side shop, you buy your Quelling Blade, and then you have Tango, Healing Salve, Stout Shield, and a Quelling Blade. And
Okay.
definitely it will help you farm a lot faster. And after that, if you feel like, okay, I do want to get a poor man's shield, then go ahead and get it. Like hero, if you, especially if you're against melee heroes in the lane, melee heroes without too much of a support. So heroes like Void, heroes like Spirit Breaker, just go for poor man's shield definitely. Or if you feel like you're gonna go and jungle a lot more, then go for poor man's shield early on. In this lane, like we'll see how your last hitting is, but let's look at
Okay.
what this guy has. You should check what your enemies have every single time when the game starts. Check them every single time, hands down. So you would have seen that this guy has one set of regen, and you would have seen that this guy has one set of regen. You've actually got two sets of regen, and your allies only got one set of regen as well. So you should have like told Bane, hey man, let's actually, Bane doesn't need more regen because he has an ability which actually gives him regen. So you should have been like, hey Bane, you should harass these guys. You should harass them as much as possible so that they run out of regen, and then we can actually kill them.
Okay.
And they will have a disadvantage in lane.
Okay.
Your camera positioning is really awkward. You should be looking like this. So right now, let's look at your screen real estate. This is half screen. This entire area is completely wasted. Nothing is happening here at all.
Okay.
It's completely wasted. Right now, the way you should be looking at screen is maybe like this, and you want to see everything that is happening
Maximize
in
my
this.
screen.
Yeah, maximize the real estate, screen real estate, right?
Okay, all right.
Okay.
So
So
my last hitting is, I have a really tough time last hitting with heroes. I know it all comes with practice, but you can see like I spam S. I used to walk around the creeps all the time, and then until a friend told me like, you know, that's actually bad. You should like stay in front of the creep and then stop, use the stop command every second. That way the enemy team has a hard time predicting when you're gonna hit that creep. So
Running around the creeps isn't bad, and pressing S isn't bad. And if you press hold, your hero just stands there, and then you can just right click at the last minute. That's not bad either. It's completely up to you. Whatever suits you, you just do whatever suits you. One point that I want to raise over here is, once again, your camera positioning is looking at yourself, literally almost in the center. You're looking at your ally, you're looking at this void space here. You have no idea where the enemies are or what they're doing right now. Your screen should be like this. This is what your screen should be like. You need to keep vision on these guys. Of course, you need to keep vision on yourself and the last sitting and everything, but you need to maximize. You don't care about your ally. You don't need to look at your ally. You need to look at these guys. You need to play like this over here.
Okay.
All right.
I'll note that. Maximize your screen.
All right. Yeah, so you've missed a couple of last hits, and those last hits definitely could have been yours if you had a Quelling Blade in that instance. Going back once again, okay, so keep in mind when somebody hits you in lane, right? They are gonna aggro creeps, right? Right now, Lina is hitting you, and right about here, she starts to aggro these three creeps. You literally did not need to, you
Run
didn't
away.
need
I
to
should have
leave.
jumped on her.
No, you didn't even need to jump on her. You should have just stood there, let her hit you. Because right now, you are actually, first of all, you're actually, we can look at.
My stats. I can tank the her attacks while the creeps attack her, and she will lose more damage.
Absolutely, yeah. Lina is attacking you for 26 damage a pop. All right, she's hitting you. Well, on average, it's not even
25.
26. It's like 22 damage. So Lina is hitting you for 22 damage, right? But if you actually look at Lina, how much damage she's taking from creeps, she is actually taking 16 damage per creep hit. Per creep hit, and three creeps are hitting her. So that is, what is that? 32 and 48 damage. She's taking twice as much damage as you are from her. One thing. Secondly, you have twice as much regen as she does. So literally, you just stand there and you just tank it and you eat a tree. She's just gonna back off by herself. So these are things that you really need to check and see. And now, when you go close to her and you attack her, these three creeps aggro to you. So you didn't let them hit you for too long. But it would have been kind of offset. That damage would have been offset. Then those three creeps would have actually done the same amount of damage to you, and then everything is like the trade is even. Actually, the creeps are still hitting you, and you don't realize it. All right. One thing that you can do is you can, using the same trick, you can actually pull these creeps back, and that's called creep
Yeah,
aggro.
creep aggro. I know
Yeah.
that. I know
Okay,
that.
if you know that, then you should use that as a melee hero. You should use that as much as possible to get farm.
Okay, especially if I'm against ranged heroes, because that closes the gap for me within the creeps.
Well, it doesn't matter which hero, ranged or melee,
But
you should always do that to get better
I was
last
told
hitting.
that even in 4K brackets, people still don't use that, and that's really a shame because it
Yeah,
can really, really help
that's
you.
why I didn't really want to tell you about it, because you would have been. Haruo had to explain it to you, and it wouldn't really help that much. But if you already know, then that's perfect. Okay, so you keep eating tangos. This is not the time to eat tangos. Your HP is way too low. You should have salved up. You needed to salve up a while ago. Okay, you
I
should
always
always.
like use this thought that I should finish the tangos first and then use the salve.
No, absolutely not. You need to use. You need. The only reason. Okay, why do you have tangos and why do you have salves? So, tangos you use when you have a little bit of HP missing. And you
Okay.
keep popping up that HP with tangos. Salve you use when you're this far down, more than 350 HP down, and you need to salve in and you use salve to get max HP immediately. Right?
Okay.
Other thing is once you run out of tangos, you need to immediately get more. When you were at
Oh,
one tango,
it's.
when you were at one tango, that's when you should have bought another set of tangos to use.
Oh, okay. Isn't that like a waste of gold? And I should probably manage the way I used my tangos and my last hitting and my fighting in the lane? Or should you just instantly get another set of tangos so I can keep surviving in the lane set of tangos?
How are you going to manage? You mean you're going to miss last hits?
Okay.
The only way to manage is to just sit back and, not farm. And that is not something you want to do. So you
Okay.
immediately bring tangos, more tangos, so you can survive more, you can keep farming. One set of tangos is going to be like two last hits. A little bit more than two
Okay.
last hits. And that's fine. That's fine. Getting a full set of tangos, which will cost you two last hits, is gonna allow you to get maybe 20 last hits, So, or and possibly kills as well.
Okay.
Okay, so at this point, you look at your inventory, you have absolutely no form of mana regen, you have absolutely no form of HP regen, and that is really, really bad, right? So you
Okay.
should always have HP and mana. You should have HP and mana regen on all your heroes. Some heroes have innate HP and mana regen, so you don't need HP and or mana regen on those particular heroes. For example, Slark has an innate HP regen, so you don't need
Yeah.
HP regen on Slark after level 6, but until level 6, you do, obviously. Same thing for mana,
Okay.
you definitely need lots of mana regen on Slark. So you should have had an Aquila, Ring of Aquila, much, much sooner than you went for your Belt of Giant Strength. Well, that's a bit
I think I actually
arguable.
skipped the ring real quick, because I thought, I should just probably rush my power treads and Shadow Blade. I think I skipped it. I'm not really
Yeah,
sure.
that's not a good idea. The other thing is that I was about to say is it's okay if you want to go for treads first and then Aquila. It's okay if you want to go for boots and then Aquila. But it all depends on how much mana you are using in lane. In this lane, you've not used any mana at all, so it's completely fine to go treads. In fact, in this lane, going for Aquila before treads would have been bad because you're not actually using the mana.
Okay. I have this like mentality. I'm really bad. Like I'm not the best at less hitting, so sometimes I skip certain items, for example, like the Ring of Basilius or Ring of Aquila, because it's like this minor item that costs a chunk of gold at the beginning that I could be using to get my core items. Because I usually get my core items really, really late. Like for example, I don't know when I got the Shadow Blade this game. I think I got it really, really late. And
The
that, it
reason
really
why
pisses me
you're
off all the
getting
time.
your core items really, really late is because you're not going for those early game items which allow you to get your core items faster. You didn't get your Quelling Blade, which doesn't allow you to get certain lasts. Like this lasted right here, guaranteed you would have gotten it if you'd had a Quelling Blade, but you just didn't have enough damage to get that lasted. Quelling Blade is extremely important on Slark, so you should never ever forgo it. Try to get it as quickly as possible. And then
Okay.
Ring of Aquila, for the stats that it gives you, and the cost, for the stats that it gives you, it is extremely cheap and cost efficient item. It costs 1,000 gold. It gives you 19 damage.
Okay.
It gives you 19 damage. It gives you an amazing 0.65 mana regen, right?
Okay.
And it gives you 3 strength, obviously, which is 60 HP. It gives you 9 agility, which is really 9 attack speed, and it gives you 36 mana, and it gives you 2 armor, which is actually 3 armor because it gives you 9 agility, so that's 1 extra armor
Okay.
almost, because seven agility is 1 armor. So it's essentially it actually gives you 3 armor. So for the stats that it gives you, it is extremely good. And once you have Aquila, it actually allows you to farm, get more last hits, farm better, allows you to get kills, allows you to farm jungle much faster. And we'll see if you actually go to the jungle, because it's actually really difficult to farm the jungle without Aquila and Treads, the way you
Okay.
Slarks do.
Yeah, you can see I'm always frustrated with my last hits.
Well, what's more important than last hits at the moment, what I see is that at this stage you have 360 HP left, and this guy's I run out of mana. But if this guy had, oh, he's actually going to the shrine. So when he comes back, if he throws out one light strike ray, you're stunned for 1.6 seconds, 80 damage, and then he throws out a dragon slave. So that in itself, just these two combined, that's 260 damage, right? And then you're stunned for 1.6 seconds. If he gets two right clicks in, which is about, what is it? It's about 100
100
damage.
damage.
Well, less than 100 damage because of mitigation. So it's 50 damage, I guess. So 200. So he's a lot by just these two. Oh, actually, she because of this, she can possibly get three right clicks. So it's about 75 damage. So just by herself, if she lands her stun on you, you
I'm
will
dead.
be like 20, 30 HP left. And then Spirit Breaker, if Spirit Breaker also charges you, 100%, there is absolutely no way you get out of that situation.
Okay.
And that's all because you did not get HP regen. This guy gave you a tango, but if you'd had if you'd bought tangos when you ran out of tangos, you would have been full HP right now, and they wouldn't even attempt to go on you. And this is the other psychological factor. If you are low, people are gonna harass you. If you are full HP, people are gonna be like, why should I waste my mana on harassing this guy when he's already full HP? So by being low, you actually invite them to make your life even more miserable. And this is even more so true in the lower brackets. Now look at what the screen. This is a really big issue that you need to work on. Right now, you don't even see the Spirit Breaker. Right now, you can just as easily click in on the mini map and start moving towards your base. So right now, the way your camera should be is here, or even here, so that you can have a little bit of vision on if somebody is TPing to this lane or not. But you want to make sure that you have perfect vision on the Spirit Breaker and on your hero. But right now, look at how weird in the corner you are. Look at all this. Once again, we draw the line in
Thingy,
the center.
I get
This is
that.
all wasted, and in this particular case, like, even this area is wasted. So you don't want to do that.
Okay. You know, a lot of the time, I'll tell you why I also sometimes do that. I think I just do that subconsciously because I'm so focused on jumping on certain heroes and doing certain tasks that repositioning my camera means moving my mouse away from doing the things like clicking on a certain hero, doing that certain thing. Yeah, I saw that, by the way.
Yeah,
No.
but once you've clicked on that hero, then you don't need to do anything more. But you need once you've clicked on a hero to fight him, then you need to actually look around that fight to see what else is happening. You've already clicked on that hero. You don't need to look at that hero anymore. You need to see if you need to get the hell out, or you need to maybe change your focus on somebody, or you need to maybe preemptively use your items like BKB or something. So you suddenly see somebody casting something on you or jumping on you or something, and immediately you want to use one of your items. Or suddenly you realize you jump on a hero, you're right clicking him, and you're looking at the team fight, and you realize, oh shit, my entire team is dead and their whole team is alive. Okay, whatever I'm doing, I need to stop doing, and I need to run the hell out of this team fight. That's not going to be
Okay.
possible if you are so focused on your one thing and you just this was a bad okay so you if you're
Okay, so why did I TP mid? I saw that mid was clear and Bane was up on the top. I thought to myself, you know what? Let's give Bane, because he's a support, give him the lane for him for like a couple, like a minute, so he can gather the XP and gold, which would be good for the support, and I'll just go farm up mid. Now,
okay
it was a bad choice because I just got fucked up and I just got pushed away like a little bitch by the team.
There's a few things here. And firstly, there is a very good reason. I'm sure there's a very okay. Firstly, the PA, whoever your mid was, he's probably coming back soon. And when he does come back, you need to leave that lane, and in that case,
Yeah.
you're gonna have to walk all the way back to the top lane and waste time, gold, all that stuff. So that's one
Okay.
reason why it was bad. Second reason, the guy it probably left the lane for a very good reason. Either the mid laner has gotten really strong, or it's a mid laner that is just hard to deal with, or there is a potential like somebody else's TP there and it's not safe to be there. So when you see a situation like this, especially this early with no vision on the map and all heroes missing, well, most heroes missing and stuff like that, you should not TP. But because of the first reason, you shouldn't have TP'd. You should have gone back to top. If top was not safe, for instance, then you can decide to go bot and push the bot tower, or you can decide to TP to this tower and go and farm jungle. But coming to the mid lane, this was not a good idea.
It was a guessing choice. I was like, oh, let's try mid. Maybe, yeah, you can see, like, I was like, okay, that was a bad choice. That was a really
Actually,
bad choice.
even if you wanted to go to the jungle, then you could have gone to the mid lane, taken a creep wave, and then gone to the jungle. But this particular decision is gonna cost you a lot. Like you just come back to lane, and you're already half HP, so it's not
Yeah,
really
that
helping
was.
you.
I was really facepalming myself at that moment. I was like, fuck this. I just fucked up really badly.
Once again, if Lina gets her stun on you, you are dead.
Yeah. Well, she missed her two nukes, so I was pretty confident at that point. So I was like, okay, if she missed two nukes, she wasted mana. I'll just focus on last hitting.
I noticed you keep tanking creeps. You should always be aware of when the creeps are hitting you. It actually makes a sound as well, so you should be listening out for that. But you can also just see that the creeps are hitting you.
Okay. Did I run away? Oh no, they tanked me. Okay.
I think you might actually run away.
Yeah, I died here.
Yeah.
Oh, wrecked me.
Once again, if you had a Quelling Blade, you okay. Maybe this is a bit high level, but
That
if you had a
Quilling Blade would have changed the entire situation.
You could have maybe eaten this tree and gone in this direction, and Lina wouldn't have maybe, or you could have eaten this tree and hid in this area. Because this is very like obviously very OP.
I pull those stuns sometimes. Even when I have a branch, I even sometimes block the path if I go for the juking moves. Yeah, I do that sometimes. It's not. I know it's high level, but I do that sometimes. Yeah, if I remember correctly, that PA was really, really terrible, and we counted on PA to be one of the carries that helps us.
Actually, PA is quite farmed. Okay, so it's 11 minutes in. You're at
I
27
remember that
HP.
her decision making was really bad, but we'll see in the replay. You can see, like, you can tell me what you think she was doing.
So, as far as your last hitting is concerned, you didn't do too poorly. Considering the lane you were in, 27 last hits is not amazing. It's actually really shit. But the fact that you were in a horrible
Thank you
lane.
for being honest.
No, you didn't let me finish. The fact that you were in a horrible lane, this CS is actually not bad. You missed a few CS. I mean, this could have been 35. Honestly, this could have been 35 if you'd had a Quelling Blade. But I don't think you get any better CS. Like, if I was in your place, maybe I would have had 40. But there's no way you could have had much better CS because it was just an impossible lane. What you're doing now is what will actually get you back into the game. But once again, for this as well, you need mana regen, and that's where Aquila, a Ring of Aquila, really comes into play. You don't
Yeah.
have mana regen right now, and
You know,
once
a
you
friend, I think I was power trading this game. Can you go back like 10 seconds ago? A friend taught me this. He told me, always use your power, always a tread switch. From int, I think I did that. I'm not sure though. Yeah, I start doing that on start every game that I play and just tread switch before you use your Q because it extremely like is meant.
It does help. It does help, but if you don't have mana regen, then it only helps to a certain degree, right? So you really need a Ring of Aquila. Now,
Okay.
at this stage, 12 minutes into the game, you've only got treads to your name,
Yeah.
right? You've got 760 HP. If Lina ults you, she takes out
Half of my
60.
HP.
No way, dude. Half of your HP is 300. 350 maybe.
400.
Yeah, 370 is your half HP. So this is more like 65% of your HP, right? Lina ults you. Okay, so let's look at the damage output from Lina. If any of these, okay, so this guy, Oracle, can actually lock you in place. Doesn't need skill shot. Just throws Fortune End at you and can lock you down. The Spirit Breaker can stun you. So if Lina gets her stun off on you, so that's 80 damage, then Dragon Slave 250 damage, so that's 330 damage. And then after 330, we add 450 damage, so that's 780 damage, right? So after reductions, you're probably gonna take around 650 damage, right? And then two more right clicks and you're dead. So there is absolutely no way you should be joining fights right now. You should, anywhere you see a fight happening, you need to run the hell out of there immediately. Four people? Hell, if you saw three people right now, you should have ran away. Anywhere, you know. But you are actually going into the fight. Yeah, oh wow, five people actually. So you just came into the fight, you did nothing, you wasted
And I
your
wasted
ult,
my ult.
which would have allowed you to escape maybe later on if somebody was ganking you. This is a good move. But that's all you did. You wasted your ult, and most importantly, you wasted your time. You could have farmed two entire jungle camps by now. You could have gone back to this lane. You could have farmed more in this lane. You know, it's not that being part of team fight is bad right now. It's
It's knowing when to.
no, it's that literally you don't contribute anything. You don't do anything. If you were doing something, then it would have been. If you were a troll warlord and you had just treads as well, first of all, look at his HP, but that's because he's got magic wand and treads. But even if you were a troll, you can actually contribute a little bit by throwing your skills from a distance. You know, if you're a Lina, you can contribute. You have nothing, but you can contribute a little bit by throwing your skills from a distance. You, on the other hand, literally cannot do anything. For you to contribute, you have to jump in to the middle of a team fight, and then you can get stunned, you will get stunned, and you will take damage. And what's going to happen is you're going to die because you don't have enough HP to tank up that much damage, right? So you needed to farm, and on a Slark, generally, you will farm until you get your what's the Invis item called? Shadow Blade. Yeah, Shadow Blade. And when you do join team fights after having Shadow Blade, you're gonna keep your treads on strength, right? It's so important that you keep your treads on strength because you need that extra 200 HP to allow you to
Survivability.
survive exactly. And that's also what the Ring of Aquila helps you with. It gives you 60 more HP. So imagine 200 HP from treads, 60 HP from Aquila. Instead of 760 HP, you're what? 900, 1,020 HP. Significantly more. Significantly more. You are trend switching, but there's a small mistake you're doing. When you trend switch to do the combo, you should have mana boots for when you, you know, press Dark Pact, and immediately afterwards, you need to put strength treads on because the way Dark Pact works is it uses.
It decreases my health, so it
Yeah.
takes me up a little.
You take 50% of the 50% of the damage. So you don't need to do stand here. You could have gone to the next jungle camp. You can regen automatically. Also, don't need to get Shadow Amulet first. You should get damage item first. This isn't really that big, to be honest. You can get items.
That I know. I had this conversation with a friend. What should I get first? The damage or the shadow amulet? I want to grab that reach, but then I saw two enemies there, so I was like, nah, I'm fucking out. I'm getting out of there.
Actually, you're wasting time again. Like, okay, you're joining this team fight, and I think this is a good team fight to join because you outnumber the enemy, and one
I was
person
actually
will only.
focusing on Lina because I knew I could kill Lina if me and another friend could catch her out of position if I pounce her.
I mean, this
But
team fight ended up being good for you, but this is not a time where you should be team fighting.
I'll tell you something. This is something, you know, when I told you when that Aura told me to focus four or three main heroes, I'll tell you why he explained to me why I should do that. When I started focusing a couple of main heroes like PA and Shadowfiend. It resolved some of the issues that I've been doing with heroes when I was very versatile. The decision making, when should I farm and when should I join battles? Like what I'm doing with right now with Slark is bad, and I'm not experienced with Slark. If it was one of those games where I was PA, I would know that I can't join this team fight because I'm not farmed enough. I know I could look at the heroes, at the situation. I can come to the conclusion I can't contribute anything. I should be doing something else. Hello, my parents are home, and they're really annoying. Guys, I'm busy. Fevre, Anya Soup. I'm sorry about that. So, the things you're seeing, like, I'm really doing a bad decision here that I'm joining team fights and stuff. I'm aware of that. It's just when I was in the game, I wasn't thinking clearly. I was just not focused, right? That's what I wanted to say. Yeah, you can continue the
Okay.
replay.
Okay. Coming back to the point, no, that's all fine. It's just that what I don't want you to do is start fighting when you're not ready. And what the thing is, right now this team fight actually went well for you. But if this team fight had not gone well for you, which is quite likely because you don't really contribute, as we said, not you don't really contribute too much. And if the enemy team had been there, like if the Spirit Breaker had been around there and charging you, you would have died. And that would have put you already don't have anything. By 14 minutes in, you should have had a Shadow Blade, but you don't. And that means if you die now, then you lose even more gold and you lose even more timing. And the problem is, the more your core items are delayed, the stronger the enemy team gets and the less impact your core items have. So you have your game is delayed, your timing is delayed, and the less your hero is actually going to do in the game. So that's why you really need to make sure that you hit your sweet timing spot and sweet timing window, and you don't take unnecessary bad team fights like this one, like these. Well, at this point, any team fight would be bad because you don't really have items. So all you should be doing right now is just farming jungle from one camp to the next camp to the next camp to the next camp, going to the lane, yeah, taking the lane farm, just farming constantly. Also, you popped your invis here. This is pretty monumental because you didn't need to use your ulti. Sorry, not invis, ulti. You know, what was the timing? So nothing was happening, nobody was going on you, and
It
suddenly,
was a
right?
reflex. I thought I was going to get targeted really heavily, so I just instantly popped it.
Yeah, but nobody actually targeted. So this is what is really important to know when you should use your ult. So in this situation, if you were about to get stunned, you should have ulted. So you might need to know who in the enemy team can stun you, and really only Spirit Breaker and Lina can. And well, Lina is dead, so really only Spirit Breaker can. So until you were really low HP, you don't need to pop in your ult. So it's really important to know these things before going into a team fight. Think about these things before going to the. You know, when you're farming and you're not thinking about anything, these are the things that you need to think about. How can I die? What are the things that I need to worry about in team fights? Who do I need to target? Like, for instance, in this game. In team fights, you need to target Oracle every single time, hands down. Doesn't even matter. Anything else doesn't matter. As soon as Oracle uses her ult, you don't need to worry about Oracle anymore. If somebody is close, you can start killing them. Or if nobody's close, just keep hitting Oracle because you can get stacks from her. You can get your essence shift stacks from her. Or him. It's a guy, apparently. I'm not sure.
It doesn't matter. Okay, I understand.
All right, so you keep coming back to the lane. This is not good because you don't have too much vision on the enemy. Especially Spirit Breaker is the one that you need to worry about. Spirit Breaker at the moment you can see, but the problem is that right like this right now, and almost died. You almost died. This is why you should not be here because you don't have a vision here. You don't see if somebody's there or not. Literally, if Oracle had, you know, I can bet you the Oracle was
Astana,
not
one
there.
more hero and I would have been dead on that spot.
Yeah, absolutely. Or if your ally hadn't been there. The only reason why you didn't die is because your ally was there. The Lina almost got one or two rifles off on you. Maybe not, because she didn't have high ground vision either. So, but this you cannot farm aggressively. You cannot farm somewhere where you don't have vision or where it's not completely safe to do so. Once again, you're going to some place that is absolutely not safe to farm.
Okay.
It's been an hour, so if you want, we can continue with this one to see what other mistakes you're making. But to be very honest with you, at this point, we can actually end the replay because we've actually looked at several mistakes that you've made in the early game. Now, usually when you make mistakes in the early game, those mistakes ripple through to the mid game and then into the late game. So the first things that you need to do is fix the mistakes
early
in the
game.
Early game. Yeah, first
okay.
Focus on the early game. You know, games are not won or lost in the early game, guaranteed, definitely, no doubt about that. But
it's a huge impact. Though.
It's a huge impact, absolutely. It's essential. So you need to focus on these mistakes and fix them. And once you get to the point where, okay, now these mistakes are fine, you've ironed them out, these basic mistakes like when to farm, when to fight, you literally cannot fight right now, so you should have been farming. Literally, if you had been farming this whole time, you guaranteed would have had Shadowblade by now, and then you just go around hunting people and killing people. Like this guy, whoa, he's got mech. 16 minutes in, he's got mech. That is actually just amazing. Chip, what?
Crazy Oracle detected.
I probably didn't buy a single ward, actually. It's not surprising.
Yes. Oh, wait, there are actually enemy wards. Or was it someone else?
Yeah,
I think
somebody else. Well, there's no enemy wards. These are all your wards.
Oh, it's our wards. Okay.
Yeah, the enemy has no wards. Okay.
All right.